Hi, hello dear students, how are you? I hope so you are doing great. This is Lakshmi. Welcome to my channel Maths Super Tips and Tricks. In this channel, I am going to teach the various levels of examinations regarding the maths, the two objective type especially for competitive level of examinations, which are mostly helpful to you. So you know in competitive level of the examination, time is important. Within short time, you have to focus on more number of questions to get best and better ranks. To get the best and better ranks, so we have to solve the more number of questions. For that, we are using the amazing super tips and tricks, shortcuts we have to follow, especially in maths. Okay, those tips and tricks only I am going to teach in my videos. Already some videos uploaded. So if you want, if you not yet watched those videos, those links are there in the below description. Please watch and enjoy those videos. Now, in today's video, exclusively I am teaching the only JE Mains point of view. That is a most and quite interesting topic and very, very important topic. At least one or two questions will come from this topic in final JE Mains. Okay, what is the topic? The topic is simply sets and relations. You know, sets and relations, so I have the idea about the sets and relations in your early classes. Already I did the one lecture on the sets. Those all points are covered in that lecture. If you not yet watched that one, compulsory, you can watch it. These links are given in the below description. Now, in this today's video, I am explaining about the relations with amazing super tips and tricks. Are you ready? Yes, without delay, let's get started, right? So there are the relations between the sets. What is the relation between the two non-empty sets? First of all, you have to know. Already I explained to you what is a non-empty set. Non-empty set is a set contains at least one element. That is called as non-empty set. There are two non-empty sets. What is a Cartesian product also I explained in the previous video. So what is a Cartesian product? Once again, briefly I will explain. So if A is one of the non-empty set like 1, 2, it contains the two elements. B is another non-empty set. It contains like P, Q, R elements. We can write the Cartesian product between the A and B. That is, we can written as A cross B. This is called as A cross B simply. Cartesian product between the non-empty sets A and B. In this example, we can observe that what is A set 1 to B set PQR. A cross B, we can write the in the form of ordered pairs like 1P is one element in this set and 1Q, 1R with 1P, 1Q, 1R and then next 2, 2P, 2Q, 2R. This is a best example, one of the best example. A and B are any two non-empty sets. How can you write the Cartesian product from A to B? It can be written as A cross B. It is a set of all order pairs. In these order pairs, we can observe that 1, 2 are from the set A and PQR from the set B. Okay. In this set, if you choose some of the elements like this, I'm taking some R1 is one of the subset of A cross B like 1P, 2P and maybe 2R if I take. You know it clearly, R1 is subset of A cross B or not? Already I explained to you what is a subset. Subsets means, well, suppose R1 in from the R1 set we can observe that 1P, 2P, 2R is in the A cross B or not? Yes, 1P is there, 2P is there, 2R is there. This is one of the subset of A cross B. Such type of subset is nothing but relation from A to B. Now, simply, what is the relation from A to B? When A and B are any two non-empty sets, relation from A to B is simply subset of a Cartesian product from A to B. It is denoted as R. So, R1 is one relation I have taken. R is always subset of A cross B, right? That's simply, what is the relation? Relation is a subset of Cartesian product of two sets A and B, right? If you choose one more subset from the A cross B, like 2P, like any elements we can choose from this set, like 1R, this is one of the subset. R2 is one of the subset of A cross B. This is also one of the relation from A to B. Is it clear? What you got about relation now? Relation is a simply subset of A cross B, where A, B are any two non-empty sets. A cross B is what? Cartesian product from A to B. That's it. Right? Now, most important point we are going to discuss now, that is called as types of relations. You know, in our family life, there are the various types of relations. Just now I explained to you. So, same way, in the maths also, there are the types of relations. What are the types of relations? If you know, that's a major part here. That's very, very important. Very easily hard to know what are the types of relations. Okay, easily can know. You have to know. There is no difficult at all. Simple way, easy way. I'm going to teach what are the types of relations. Just you can follow them. Even if you have any doubts regarding those, put a comment. I'm ready to rectify your doubts. Clear? Just know only I have given illustration about the definition of the relation. Relation is a subset of A cross B. I said, what is general definition of relation? Just you have to know first of all. Let A, B, R, B two non-empty sets. I said already R is subset of A cross B. Then R is taken as some combination of order pairs A, B. What is A? A is a contains in the set A. Small a is a belongs to set A. And B is belongs to set B. This is also denoted as A, R, B. It is called it as A related to B. All order pairs we can take. Generally, one order pair are taken AB and mention that this is called a set builder form, you know very well. So in this clearly set AB such that where A belongs to A and B belongs to B, then R is related from two non-empty sets A and B. And what are the AB are? Elements which are in A and B. It is also can be written as ARB means A is related to B. Now we have to know what are the major types of relations, right? Now we can observe the one of the relation, identity relation. Every element of A is related to itself. Means what? 1 is related to 1, 2 is related to 2, x is related to x, etc. That is called as identity relation. Like A is related to A, B is also same as A, right? And where forever A belongs to a set A. Now, inverse relation. Inverse relation is what? Suppose R is subset of A cross B, then inverse is R inverse, it can be written as R inverse is subset of B cross A. A becomes B, B becomes A. Means what? Set A is called as actually domain of R, set B is called as domain, what is that called? Range of R. But in case of inverse R inverse, B to A becomes. For example, suppose AB belongs to R. Can you guess? Yes, reverse of this, BA belongs to R inverse. So we can use order pairs. By using order pairs, we can find out inverse relation, right? For example, if I take in R is one of the set, like 1, 2, 3, 4. One, R is one of the relation set of the elements 1, 2, 3, 4. What is its inverse? R inverse is simply 1, 2, we can read it, I take it as 2, 1. And 3, 4, we can becomes 4, 3. The order pairs AB becomes BA, like R inverse, right? So, means simply AB belongs to R, then BA belongs to R inverse. This is inverse relation. These are the some relations, you know, we have to know the basic types of relations. These are the very, very, very important. What are the basic types of relations we have to know? Have written here. Just shall I? So it's very easy. There is no difficult at all. Now we can observe the what are the major types of relations. I will explain with the illustrations, then you can understand easily, right? You know, in this major relations, types of relations, reflexive. which relation is called as reflexive relation. In this given definition, forever A belongs to R if and only if A belongs to R, means for those elements are same, then only it is a reflexive. Forever A belongs to A, for every element it must be. If you left the one of the element, it's not a reflexive. Let us see this example. Suppose if I take the A is one of the set 1, 2, 3 set. A is one of the set 1, 2, 3. If I taken like this set of 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. We can observe that here in this set, what happened? All these elements are similar, like 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3 are compulsory is in A. If you left any one of them, is not a reflexive. This is clearly reflexive relation. Suppose if I take like this 1, 1, 2, 2 only, is it a reflexive? It's not a reflexive because of 3 is not appears here. 3, 3 is not there, that's why it's not a reflexive relation, right? Reflexive simply, if A related to A, then it is called as reflexive relation, right? Now we can come to the next, symmetric relation. If A is related to B, then B is related to A, then only it is a symmetric relation. In this example, one more example I'm giving to you for the symmetric S. If I take like this 1, 2, there must be 2, 1. 1, 2 is there, suppose, indirectly there must be 2, 1. Then only it will be, what is that, symmetric. Otherwise, it is not a symmetric. One more example I'm giving to you. Like 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2. Is it here symmetric? Is it a symmetric? For 2, 3, 3, 2 is there, but 1, 2, no 2, 1. That's why it is not a symmetric. Clear? If element is available like AB, that connect to BA must be, then only it is a symmetric. Otherwise, not a symmetric. In this example, 2, 3, symmetric, 3, 2 is there, but 1, 2, no 2, 1. But here, for 1, 2, 2, 1 is there. Clear? This is symmetric. Now, trans 2. If A is related to B and B related to C, if A is related to B, B related to C, compulsory. Suppose, compulsory means if suppose, if A is related to C, if A related to B and B related to C, then if A is related to C, then this is a, that relation is called as transitive. Clear? What is transitive relation? If A is related to B, B is related to C, then A is related to C, then only it is a transitive. We can observe this example. One more example I will give to you for transitive. Set of parallel lines. Set of parallel lines. You know, L1 is parallel to L2, suppose if you take, and L2 is parallel to L3. There are three types of lines, L1, L2, L3. Suppose L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. So 100% you know that clearly L1 is parallel to L3. Okay. So if suppose if you take L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3, 100% you know that clearly L1 is simply parallel to L3, then this example set of parallel lines forms a reflexive transitive relation. We are going to explore transitive relation. Okay, for example, here according to this statement, L1 parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. You know L1, L2 parallel, L2, L3 parallel, 100% you know that clearly these two are parallel, not these two are clearly parallel lines. Hence, set of parallel lines form a transitive relation. Clear? So like this, we can use any statement, not only numbers, not only like lines, any statement we can observe that relations follows or not, you have to observe that. Clear? You know what is a reflexive? If A is related to A, For every A belongs to A, then it is only reflex. What is trans to? If A is related to B, then B is related to A, then the relation is trans to symmetric. If A is related to B and then B is related to A, then the relation is symmetric. What about trans to? If A is related to B and B is related to C, then A is related to C, then it is called as trans to. Clear? I given this example, set up the lines trans to, and so many examples are given, 2-3 examples are given. Now can come to the equivalence relation. Equivalence relation, simply a relation follows the above three, like reflex, symmetric, trans to, then it is said to be equivalence relation. It must be follows reflex, symmetric, trans to. Clear? If any one of them are failed, like reflex failed, it's not a equivalence. It must be follows three of the relations. Reflex, yes, what are that? Reflex, symmetric, trans to, then the relation is equivalence relation. Is it clear? These are the major types of relations. For example, equivalence relation, you know, set of parallelines is 100% equivalence relation. Why it is? Already I said to you, this is trans to. In case of reflex, so suppose if it is reflex or not, you know, every line is parallel to itself. You know, 100% L is parallel to L. This is clearly reflex. And second case, symmetric, we can observe that. Symmetric. You know, L1 is parallel to L2. 100%, you know that clearly? L2 is parallel to L1. Therefore, it is clearly symmetric. Already I explained to you, trans to. L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. Then, L1 is 100% parallel to L3. So, therefore, what you can observe that in this example, set of parallel lines is an equivalence relation, right? Because it follows reflexive, symmetric, as well as transfer. Now, we can come across some more examples. Clear? Right. Let's look at these illustrations. First one, which of the following reflexive relation on the set A? 1, 2, 3. Which of the following is reflexive relation we have to recognize on the set of the elements 1, 2, 3. So, we can observe that what is reflexive relation, I said? Yes, for every element of A, element itself only related. Like, is it reflexive? What is the first element? 1, 1. Second element? 2, 2. Okay. Third element? 3, 1. Not 3, 3. That's why it's not a reflexive. Clear? Now, every element, not only two elements. Here, 1, 1, 2, 2, okay, but 3, 3 is not there. Now, can come to the second one. 1, 1, 2, 2, here also 3, 3 not there. Right. Third one. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Yes. This is clearly reflexive. Here, 1, 1, 3, 3 only there. No, 2, 2. Right. This is clearly reflexive. For every element, as a reflect itself. That is only reflex, right? Now come to the question number 2. Which of the following is symmetric relation on set A? Same set argument for your understanding purpose. Set of 1, 2, 3 elements, which is symmetric. What I said about symmetric? There is a AB compulsory. The connection with the AB is BA. Then only it is symmetric. We can, for this question, I'm explaining from the fourth option onwards. Reverse order, like first to fourth option. 1, 1, 2, 2, yes. 1, 1 reflection is 1, 1. 2, 2 reflection is 2, 2. 3, 2 reflection must be 3, 2. 3, 2 is there. Is there 2, 3? No, that's why it's not a symmetric. Now come to the third one. 2, 3 is there. Is there any 3, 2? No. One element is rejected. That's enough. Now 1, 3, yes, 3, 1 is there. 2, 3, 3, 2 is there. But 1, 2, no, 2, 1. Right? This is not a symmetric. What about first option? Yes, 1, 1 reflection is 1, 1, right? 1, 3 reflection is 3, 1. It's clearly symmetric. Like that, we can recognize a reflex and a symmetric orbitals. Clear? So, these are the two types of relations I explained. Some more relations I'm going to discuss, right? Look at 3 and 4. Before start the 3 and 4, I will give the some tips which are useful wherever maybe we need. How many relations we can form from set A to B, and how many symmetric relations of a set A can form from set A contains so on elements. Similarly, how many reflex relations can be formed those we can use wherever maybe we need. Suppose there are the n elements, n of A contains m elements, n of B contains the n elements. What is n of A means? The number of elements in a set A, m, and the number of elements in set B is n. Then the number of relations from A to B. Number of relations from A to B is simply 2 power mn. This is one tip. This is used to find out the number of relations from set A to set B when A contains m elements, B contains n elements. It is clear? Is it clear? Now, suppose there are the n elements for our convenience. Maybe already you know n of A is equals to m. Number of reflex relations from set A to itself, that is number of reflexes, can be collect by using this one 2 power m square minus m. By using 2 power m square minus 1, we can get how many reflex relations formed of a set contains m elements, right? Now, same set contains m elements, how many symmetric relations can be formed? Symmetric relations, we can use the 2 power of sigma m. You know sigma m means what? Sum of first m natural numbers. Is it clear now? We are using wherever maybe he may go. Okay, these tips are also useful. Some questions, right? Now we can look at the question number 3 and 4. What is the question number 3? Which of the following is not transitive? Not transitive on set A contains 3 elements 1 to 3. Now you can observe that option number 1. You know what is transitive? If A related to B and B related to C, if then A related to C. What is that? A to B, B to C, then A to C. It is clearly transitive. You can see one by one. First option 1, 1. Here 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1 is there. 1, 2, 2, 1 means what? There is 1, 1 is also there. A, B, B, C, then A, C also there. It is clearly transitive. You feel that. But it is wrong because of, you know, in case of the set, elements order is not important. If take the order 1, 2, 2, 1, okay, it is 1, 1. But if you take the order in reverse, like if you take 2, 1 is first one, 2, 1, and 1, 2, 1, 1 as it is. Okay, 2, 1, 1, 2. 2, 1 related and 1, 2 related, then for transitive, 2, 2 must be related. Is it there 2, 2? Is there 2, 2? No, it's not a transitive. That is only our required solution. What is asking me? Which of the following is not transitive on the set A? Is it clear? 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1 is there. But in case of 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2 is not there. We can observe that remaining 3 are transitive. Why it is? See, 1, 1. Okay, 1, 3, 3, 1. 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1 is there. 3, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3 is there. Therefore, this is transitive. But he is asking which of them is not a transitive. Now, this is not a transitive. One option is only correct one. Remaining also, I am explaining for your easy understanding purpose. Now, option number 3. 1, 2, 2, 1 is 1, 1. Yes, it is there. Suppose if you take the 2, 1, 1, 2, it must be 2, 2 is also there. Therefore, this is also transitive. Now, fourth one. 3, 2, 2, 3. 3, 2, 2, 3 is 3, 3, 3. And if you write the 2, 3, 3, 2. 2, 3, 3, 2 must be 2, 2 is there. Yes, it is a transitive. Therefore, among the 4 options, which is not a transitive, it is clearly first option. Clear? Right. So, now come to the next bit. Fourth question. Let A is given as set 1, 2, 3, 4 elements. And R be a relation on set A given by. One of the relations is given on set A contains 4 elements 1, 2, 3, 4. We can observe that then R is reflex, symmetric, transitive, and equivalence relation we have to recognize. If any one of them is failed, then it is not an equivalence relation. Fourth option automatically eliminated. Equivalent relation means what? A relation must be reflex, symmetric, transitive, then only it is an equivalence relation. First of all, you can look at the reflex. Here, what are the elements here? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 1 is there. 2, 2 is there. 3, 3 is there. 4, 4 is there. Yes, it is reflexive. Okay, symmetric. We can observe that. Symmetric, there is 1, 1, 1, 1 is there. 2, 2, 2 is there. 3, 3, reverse 3, 3. 4, 4, 4, 4. 1, 2, 2, 1. Yes, it is there. 1, 3, 3, 1. 1, 3 connect to 3, 1 is also there. It is clearly symmetric also. Now trans 2. Trans 2, you can come to these elements first. 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2, 1 is 1, 1 is there. Now 1, 3, 3, 1 is also 1, 1 is there. And 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 1. 2, 2, 2, 1. How much? 2, 1. Yes, 2, 1 is there. 2, 2, 2, 1. Again 2, 1 is there. Right? Don't get the confusion. Like 1, 2, 2, 1 is 1, 1 is there. Every element is there. Okay, it is follows what? Trans 2 also. If it follows the reflexive symmetric trans 2, what that relation is called as? Equivalence relation. Is there option? Equivalence relation means what? Among the four options, you have to choose only fourth option. If these three are true, automatically fourth option is only correct one. You can pick up the fourth option. Clear, easy way how to recollect what are the relations. These four examples, 1, 2, 3, 4, are given only on the set of elements. Set contains finite number of elements like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, like. Not only sets, he may give any statements. Sets means it's not a finite set. He may give any statement. According to the statement, those rules must be true. What are those? Reflexive, symmetric, transitive. If those rules follow, then only it is an equivalence relation. Maybe sometimes given a statement may be reflexive, not symmetric like that also. You will give the different types of statements. What are those? We can come across one by one. Are you ready? Are you following? It's so easy, you know. So if there are any doubts even though, please put a comment. Clear? Look at the question number 516. What about question number 5? R is a relation over set of integers. R is one of the relation is given over set of integers. You know, integers 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on, infinity, as well as 0. 0 is also one of the integers. Such that given by the relation, relation in the form of x, y belongs to R. What is its follows? Mod x minus y is must be less than equals to 1. Means what? We have to recognize the relation is. Which type we have to recognize? For that, we have to use this statement mod x minus y less than equals 1. It must be followed forever x, y belongs to R. Clear? How we can recognize here? Then, given that four options like this, first option reflexive and transitive, reflex and symmetric, and so on. He has given for this from here onwards. I am writing for reflexive R letter. Okay, first I am verifying the reflexive. Reflexive or not, I am verifying it. Reflex, for reflexive case, you know, A related to A, then only it is reflexive. For every A belongs to set of integers here. Suppose if A belongs to integer sum I, mod of, in place of x, y also you can take it as A. Maybe you can take x also. Only x in place of the, this is we can take x also. You know, x is belongs to R. What this R is? X is belongs to integers. I we can take it as integer letter. What I'm verifying now? Reflexive or not, I'm verifying. For reflexive, two letters must be equal. You know, x belongs to I. What is the definition? X minus y must be less than equals to 1 under modulus. That is x minus x. What is x minus x value? 0 under modulus. It is 100% less than equals to 1. It is true. Clearly less than. Okay. For every x belongs to integer. Mod x minus x is clearly 0. It is clearly reflexive. Okay. Right. Now come to the symmetric or not. For symmetric, I am using S letter. If x is related to y, suppose x is related to y, if it is y is related to x, then only it is a symmetric. You know, suppose xy belongs to integers I, mod x minus y is less than equals to 1. If we take, can we get from this mod y minus x also less than 1? Yes, easily can get because of, you know, by taking the minus is common, minus of y minus x is less than equals to 1. under modulus minus becomes plus, means mod y minus 6 is also less than 1. Mod x minus y is less than equals to 1, it's also in plus. Mod y minus 6 also less than equals to 1 forever x y belongs to integers. Therefore, it's clearly symmetric. Reflex under symmetric. Which option is correct one? Only second option. We can think about the trans 2. Suppose x minus y is less than equals to 1 and y minus z is less than equals to 1, but x minus z is not at all less than equals to 1. We can verify yourself also. So that's why only one of the option is correct one. Reflex under symmetric. You know, from the among 1-2 options, reflex is 100% true. In 1-2 options, there is what? Symmetric. Symmetric also true. Therefore, it's not a trans 2. No need to concentrate on remaining 3 and 4 options. Clear? Right. Now, can come to the question number 5. 6. Let a relation R be the defined. One of the relations given in terms of R. Then is asking the R inverse circle R. R inverse means what? Inverse relation. You know, circle is clearly composite function. You know, from the functions f circle, j, j circle, f, we are doing the same way. But here we are using a relation. For that, first to find out R inverse circle f, R inverse circle R, we can use R first. What is R given? 4, 5, 1, 4, 4, 6, and 7, 6, 3, 7 is R. Now, we can take R inverse, it's inverse. 4, 5, 5, 4. For 1, 4, 4, 1. 4, 6, 6, 4. We can take in reverse order. 7, 6, 6, 7. Now, 3, 7, 7, 3. Right? You know, from the functions, one of the notation is there, same way also. If R is related to A to B, and R inverse is from B to A. So, R inverse circle R from B to A, this is. Okay, R is related to A to B, R inverse B to A, then R inverse circle R from A to A. What is a common letter? We can avoid that one, A to A. Okay? What is a common here? B. B combination is in R, A to B and R inverse B to A. What is a common here? Middle B. That one you should avoid. You know, in case of functions, f from A to B, G from B to C, then G circle f from A to C. Like here, relations we are using. That is only difference here and there. Now we can concentrate what we want. R inverse circle R. To find out R inverse circle, we can take first R first, then only R inverse. Don't take R inverse first. Okay, now come to the combination one by one. 4, 5. 5 is starting where from here? 5, 4. 5, 4, with 5 only one element is there, right? 4, 5, 5, 4 is 4, 4, right? Right. Next element. 1, 4, then 4 starting here. 4, 1. Any there? Yes. No, only 4, 1. 1, 4, 4, 1 is 1, 1, right? Next. 4, 6. For 4, 6, so 6, 4 is there, these two. 4, 6, 6, 4, it is a 4, 4. Already 4, 4, once you have written, don't take again because of in the sets, elements, repeated elements, you cannot take. Okay, 4, 4 already is there. Right, 4, 6, 6, 4, 4, 4 already is there. 4, 6, again 6, 7. 4, 6, 6, 7, 4, 7, right? Anywhere else? 6 with 6, no, these two only. Now, 7, 6. 7, 6 with 6, 6, 4. 7, 6, 6, 4 is 7, 4. Like that, you have to concentrate. 7, 6, again 6 starting with here also. 7, 6, 6, 7 is 7, 7, right? Next, next element. 3, 7. Here in a 7, 3. 3, 7, 7, 3, only one element, 3, 3. That's it. This is only our R inverse circle. R. It's very simple. Simple way how to concentrate. For example, 4, 5. 5 is where here? Here, 5, 4. The 5, 4 first element is 5. It is only one element, no other element. 4, 4, like that. 1, 4 with 4 starting 4, 1, only one element. 1, 4, 4, 1 is 1, 1, right? 1, 1. Now, 4, 6 for, with the 6 here, 2 elements are there. 6, 4 is there, 6, 7 is there. 4, 6, 6, 4 is 4, 4. 4, 4 already have taken, don't take repeatedly. Now, 4, 6, 6, 7 is a 4, 7. Yes, right. Now 7 6 6 again, 2 are here. 7 6 6 4 is 7 4. Is it clear? Now 7 6 6 7 is 7 7. Now last 3 7 7 with 7 3s. 3 7 7 3 is 3 3. This is on our R and R circle. R, which option is correct one? 1 1 4 4 4 7 7 4 7 7 3 3. It is clearly second option. That's it. Clear? Look at the 7 and 8. What about 7th question? If A is a set of even natural numbers less than 8, you know what are the even numbers? The two natural numbers can starting from 2 2 4 6 8 and so on. But here numbers less than 8 means set A contains natural numbers less than 8 means there are the three elements, that is 2 4 6. Clear? Now B, and the B is set of prime numbers less than 7. What are the prime numbers less than 7? Yes, exactly, 2 3 5. Only three elements. Set of the prime numbers less than 7, that is 2 5 7. Okay, A contains how many elements? 3 elements. B contains how many elements? 3 elements. What is asking? The number of relations from A to B. So here M is a 3, N is also 3. I have given to you number of relations. What is that? Number of relations from A to B is a 2 power MN, that is 2 power of 3 into 3 9, 2 power 9. That is clearly first option. Just we can use the tip, how many relations we can form from A to B when AB contains M and N elements respectively. Clear? Now come to the question number 8. Let R be the relation over the set of straight lines of a plane such that they are perpendicular. Means indirectly set of perpendicular lines are given. Then we can recognize that then R is reflexive but not symmetric, symmetric but not reflexive, and so on. Set of perpendicular lines here, you know, 100% it's not at all reflexive, because every line is parallel itself, not perpendicular. So that is L is not perpendicular to L, therefore it's not a reflexive. So which option? Not reflexive means reflexive and translate, reflexive is there, it's not at all correct. Okay, we can check next. Then symmetric, I'm checking, it's not a reflex, symmetric. You know, I will explain with the figure. Suppose L1 here, L1 is perpendicular to L2. L1 is perpendicular to L2, automatically L2 is also perpendicular to L1. So L1 is perpendicular to L2, which 100% implies L2 is also perpendicular to L1. It is clearly symmetric. It's not reflexive but symmetric. Okay, now we can think about the trans 2. I will explain with the figure. Suppose L1 is perpendicular to L2. L2 is perpendicular to L3. L1 is perpendicular to L2. L2 is perpendicular to L3. Is it L1 is perpendicular to L3? No, L1 is here parallel to L3. Therefore, it's not a trans 2. Clear? So, it is only symmetric. Okay, which we can check, which option? Reflexive but not symmetric. It is not at all reflexive. Means not a first option. Symmetric but not reflex. Yes, symmetric but not reflex is correct one. This reflex on the transitive, it is not at all correct. Reflective is not, transitive is also not. Then only transitive. Therefore, which option is correct one? Second option. Is it clear? Like that, we will frame the various types of questions. Right? See the question number 9. What is that? Let R be a relation over the set of integers such that M is related to N. Then like A related to A, M, N are given, A related to B, like M, N related. If and only if M is a multiple of N, then the R is. What is given? M is related to N. What is the condition here? M is multiple of N. Then the relation R is reflexive or symmetric or transitive or equivalent, we have to check. So multiple means what, you know? Divisors. Suppose let M is equals to KN if you take, where K is any multiple. So M is multiple of N with any integer K. First we can check about the reflection. For reflection, you know, both letters must be equal. You know, M is 100% equals to M, where K is what here? K is clearly 1. m is equals to 1 into m is 1. It is clearly m is 100% multiple of m. Therefore, it is clearly reflex. Right? Now, symmetric. For symmetric, we can check. Suppose m is k times of n. From that, we can take n is k times of m or not. Suppose m is equals k times of n. Means m is a multiple of n. Then n is what here from this one? N is m by k. Is it possible for all cases? It's not possible when k is a 0. Because if k is 0, this is undefined. Therefore, it is not possible when k is 0. One case is rejected, that's enough. For k is equal to 0, n is not multiple of m. Therefore, m is multiple of n, but n is not multiple of n. Because if k is 0, it is impossible. Therefore, it is not a symmetric. Now, transitive, we can observe that. For transitive, suppose m is equals to multiple of n with k 1 times and n is multiple of some m and p, some k 2 times of p, right? Now, we have to check m is multiple of k 2 times of p or not. M to n, n to p, then m to p. So, now we can check it. M is equals to kn, k1 n, you know. K1 n place of n, we can write k to p. Therefore, m is equals to k1, k2 or any integers. Product of two integers is also one of the integers. Let it be k is p. So, m is a multiple of n. N is multiple of p. 100% m is multiple of p. Therefore, it is clearly transitive. Okay, it is reflex and transitive but not symmetric. Clear? Right. Now, we can come to the next question. Is given that letter W denotes the words in a dictionary, English dictionary. There are the words, you know, in English dictionary. W is mentioned as a word. Define the relation R by. R is given as, let XY belongs to W versus W. Two words relation is given. What is the condition here? The words X and Y have at least one letter is in common. We have to choose the words so that at least one letter is a common. Those forms are reflex or symmetric or transitive, you have to check. It is clearly 100% you know reflex because every word has a letters itself only common letters. Therefore, it is clearly for that reflex. And suppose A is one of the word if you take, every letter in A is itself only common, right? And about transitive, suppose the letter at least one letter is common in word A and in word B. Same way, the same letter is common in word B to word A also. Therefore, it is clearly 100% symmetric. But transitive need not be. Transitive need not be. Suppose A letter is A word to B word, there are the common letters. And B word to C word, there are the common letters. But need not be common letters between A to C. Of it is, just I will explain one of the example. You know, general example, what you know. Like IIT is one of the word and AIEEE is another word and one more word JEE if I take. Okay, you know this is W1, W2, W3, three types of words are taken such that you know in W1 and W2 at least one letter is common, you know Y is common in both the words and so and next W3. In the next two words AIEEE and JEE, what letter is common? E is common, right? But what about W1 and W3? Is there any common letter? No, even no single common letter. So, it's not a transitive. Is it clear now? There is a common letter W1 to W2, S, I. There is a common letter W2 to W3, E. But there is no question of common letter from W1 to W3. It's not a transitive. Clear? You know, every word itself only common letters, it is clearly symmetric. You know, suppose this is a these, if you take these two, what are the common letter? Only one letter is common, I. Same way, here to here also I is there. It's symmetric, reflex, but not transitive. It is rejected. Maybe some words coincide, but it's not applicable to all words, right? Therefore, this is a clearly not a transitive. It is reflex, symmetric, but need not be transitive. Clear? So, these are the various questions. Side it depends on relations. Hope so you enjoyed well. So if you make sure if you enjoy this video, please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to add your valuable comments. We'll see you in next video with a new topic, with a new energy. Till then, keep work hard and have a great time. Okay, bye bye.